I want to tell you that you are special, you're gifted, and you're talented. The Bible tells us that you and me have been fearfully and wonderfully made. You know, we are not part of any batch manufacturing process like how it happens in factories. When God created individuals, He did it with great thought, with precision, and with detail. And man is not just about intellect or personality. Those are important traits. But another important aspect, everyone has been endowed with specific talents. And it's when you and me engage with these talents, we end up living out our divine purpose. So how can I identify it? Well, look at those areas, look at those activities. When you engage with those activities, you feel so passionate about, you feel so excited about, you feel so alive. What are those activities? What are those activities when you engage with others around you, say, hey, thank you for doing that. I feel so blessed. You've helped me by doing this. What are those activities that you'll do free of cost for the love of those activities? Well, that could be your area of talent. The next thing that you got to do is embrace your talent. The mistake that we often do is to compare our talents with somebody else's talent. And in our mind, we seem to have this hierarchy of talent. This is a higher talent, this is a lower talent. There is no such thing like that. It's important for you and me to understand that talents are specific and diverse, right? Talents could range from dancing to debating, from pottery to poetry. So talents are diverse, talents are specific. And therefore, it's important to accept the talent that you've given and to hone that talent by working at it. Often we make the mistake that I will exercise my talent or I will value my talent basis what is the probability of monetary gains I get by using that talent. Okay, let's say if I have a talent of singing, well, probably it's got a higher probability of me earning more versus a talent of just being hospitable to people, right? You never evaluate talents basis monetary gains. And if ever you want to have a linkage between monetary gains and talents, well, it doesn't work that way. What really works is when you're excellent at something, when you're gifted at something, that is when there's a linkage between monetary gains. Take Roger Federer, for example, right? That tennis superstar. He displays excellence every time he plays tennis. And that's why we call him gifted. And because he's gifted, there's a direct monetary gain besides the pleasure that he brings with us. So please understand, it's excellence which gives the benefits and not talent by itself, right? The third thing that I want to bring to your notice is, talent is in its raw form. But when you work on that talent, when you hone the skill of those talents, a talent gets converted to strength, right? It's a superior form of raw talent. And on a strength, if you engage with it with patience, with perseverance, it becomes a gift. And that's why we say commonly, this person is gifted in singing, this person is gifted with art. How did the gift happen? Because somebody took a talent, made it a strength, and worked with it with patience and perseverance until it became a gift. Somebody beautifully summed it up by saying is, talent is God's gift to you. And what you do with your talent is your gift to God. So remember this, you are fearfully and wonderfully made. Identify those talents, embrace those talents, and engage with your talents.